Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. This is an all-important video that many of you have asked for. Things that you can do on your own time and space that make you look younger. It's really important to share this one with your friends because I think you can make a difference in someone's life. What if there was something you could easily do, no cost to you, to make your skin look better? What if it only took 20 to 30 minutes per day? What if it was even scientifically proven to work? This has been proven to help not only your skin now and going forward, but also even reverse, yes, I said reverse, skin damage and things that you've already done to your skin. A lot of times people are exposed to sun, they have sagging, they have signs of aging that have built up over the years and they just don't know where to start. Well, this can reverse some of those signs and people have been shown to look 10, even 20 years younger if they're partaking. On this channel, we're concerned about skin, but as an added bonus to this one thing, it can help with many other aspects of general health, and better yet, it doesn't involve injections, creams, lotions, or potions. It's all natural. It's not PRF. We often talk about platelet-rich fiber, and it's not injections, but it's 100% all natural. Would you be interested in this? I see it as a common denominator in my patients. Those who do this definitely are easier to work on. I can get better results. Everything lasts longer. And sometimes I only see them once, maybe twice a year, as opposed to other people, I might see every 2 to 3 months. So it absolutely does seem to work well, and it often gives better bone structure. Remember, when you lose bone, it's been found now to be one of the quickest areas of aging is when people lose bone, and they're losing it in their 30s. That's leading to lines, wrinkles, and folds. So stay tuned to the end because I'm also going to tell you, if you partake in this, there is some skincare you should be using to maximize the benefit. And I'm going to give you two different things you should be on. Remember to like, subscribe, and please share these videos with your friends. So I went to school and got my medical degree at the University of Western Ontario in Canada. 60 miles away was another school called McMaster University. And that's where they did a recent study, which applies to us here on this channel. They took mice, which were bred to age very rapidly. So if you take the mouse and it ages quicker than a normal one, in that way you can complete the study very rapidly, but also you can study very many variables because they go through their life cycle quickly. They took one group called the control group, and that's often the problem with anti-aging, skincare, fillers, anything you do. How do you know what you would look like if you didn't do any of those? And if you took two people and you gave one the treatment, say someone had fillers and Botox and everything, and one person didn't, if they weren't identical twins with the same exposures, the genetic differences are too diverse. So a control group is key. In mice, you can actually look at that pretty well. In their control group, they had mice that were sedentary, meaning they had low levels of activity. The other group, or the treatment group, had activities and they ran on that treadmill. The mice love running on that treadmill. And that was considered the treatment group, was the exercise. Hint, hint. I know you didn't want to hear me talk about exercise, but I want to show you the science behind it. The mice in the activity group were then studied and had better organ function, less dementia, and in fact, every aspect of their well-being improved, and they even looked better to the naked eye. So if you look at the mice, and I saw some in the study, they looked younger and more vibrant than the other mice. You could pick it out with the naked eye. You didn't even need to study the biological or chemical properties or check their cells out, which was done. Yes, the fur was less gray, and yes, they had a healthier coat. But why was the effect seen? That's really the question. It seems to be something to do with their mitochondria, which are the power centers for the cells that produce and generate energy. ATP and telomeres, of course, are a great study for anti-aging. And certainly the mitochondria of the energy components of our cell seem to play an important role. And anyone here who follows anti-aging would know about all the drugs and factors to alter the mitochondria, the telomere length. All that might be familiar to you because it's talked about in the literature and even you hear it in the news. The exercise mice even had fewer mutations when they studied them and less signs of cellular damage. This is important because mutations can lead to cancer and cancer changes within the cells. Now, you're saying, great, okay, so the mice did better with exercise. That could be on many levels, but what about humans? How does it apply to us? And it is hard to study humans, as I said, but at the same school, at McMaster, they looked at humans. And because it's very important to that we shouldn't extrapolate. So they took skin samples from humans. Now, it's hard to take, you know, if someone comes to take a skin sample from, you're like, whoa. Well, they took them from inconspicuous areas. That's what we do. And with filler and different things, we take them from the back of the ear. Of course, there isn't sun exposure there. So that affects how we take it. But what they took it for was from the buttocks area because they were interested in looking at more the cellular function and why it might occur, because a lot of times you're looking for why did something happen. If you can explain why, that kind of tells you that yes, it did work. So they took those samples from those areas, so don't be worried about that part. What they found was interesting. Healthier skin in the exercise group, and it seemed to be, again, something in the mitochondria or the energy centers of the cells. It doesn't stop there, and this is the important part, because they then took the sedentary people of the study and exercised them. So they initially looked at people that were sedentary versus exercise for 4 hours or more a week, looked at their skin, found those differences, and then they took the sedentary people who didn't have the best cellular function, they exercised them, and guess what? Their healthy mitochondria increased, as did their physical appearance. So you could see it on the outside. They looked younger and their skin was better. It seems like, and I talked about the mechanism, it was interleukin 15. So they even had what's released from the muscles of the patient. And so they found that factor was increased in exercise, and it kind of all adds up. There's also the theory of increased blood flow. I talk about that a lot because when we look at skincare and people put skincare on one side of the face and they only massage a placebo on the other, the placebo group gets more improvement than what we would expect from just placebo, which is around 40%. And they did realize that increased blood flow can help it. And of course, exercise will increase blood flow as well. How long does it take? Because you're asking, okay, I'll exercise in 3 years, I might see a difference. No, just 3 months is what the study did. The sedentary people exercised for 3 months and they found those changes. So what are my tips if you're going to exercise? Of course, sometimes people lose too much weight. So I don't like addictive exercise, but something you have fun with. Runners and cyclists sometimes are a little over the top, and I see them, and we have to do a lot of sculpture to add facial volume back, and that kills the machinery of the cells. It's not a healthy level of exercise, but rather 20 to 30 minutes a day. What are the two skincare products you should be on? Number one, a lot of people get more sun exposure if they're active. So SPF 30 and above. It doesn't have to be more than 30. So 30, after 30, you don't get that much more benefit, but reapplying is important because there's no use exercising if you're a runner or cyclist and you're out in the sun getting more sun damage than what your exercise is going to help you with. Number two, I want to add a third, but number two and three, vitamin C and or niacinamide. Vitamin C is probably more important because it's been shown to help reverse the signs of sun damage, solar elastosis, and the effects of sun. And vitamin C will also help with the machinery of your collagen and your hyaluronic acid production. Exercise. Absolutely key. It does so many things, helps your generalized health. I put a playlist up here on home treatments you can do for your skin to make it beautiful, healthy, and vibrant. Stay tuned here. What's the next group of videos you would like to see? Let me know in the comments.